I'm here in one of the many studios that Neighbours films in. Behind me, Harold's Cafe, of course. The Kennedys is right there, and I can see the interior of Lasseter's as well. It's all just sets and props, I get that. But let's be honest, for the last 37 years, haven't we all fallen in love with all of the characters and families that have called all these places home?
I think it's kind of like, you know, the comfortable couch in your house that you kind of forget about and you take for granted, really.
If I had to guess, I would say they're recognisable. There is something about Harold that reminds everyone of someone in their lives. There's a Carl and a Susan in everyone's lives, or they would like a Carl or a Susan to be in their lives. I think the characters ultimately have heart.
Amnesia.
Yeah.
Deaths.
Yep.
Marriages and everything else in between.
Don't ever move into Ramsay Street.
I believe the best man lives here.
By that, great party.
I was super excited. Yeah, I came in like for a short for a role called Cyborg. Who was a vandal, and that was on location, and that was one day.
How did you get the call that your one scene was going to be a recurring character, and how did that make you feel?
Oh, I never got a call about that it was going to be a recurring character. It was just...
Can you come back?
Can you come back? And
has that been going on for the last 20 years or so?
Pretty much, yeah. I always think that I'm going to get
good
fired.
News. We want you back next week.
Yeah, well, I suppose it has come true. 27 years later, yes. I have been fired, finally.
Has it been fun being the bad guy?
Oh, God, yeah.
Multiple marriages.
Yeah.
Multiple attacks on people's lives,
yeah.
Both, you know, financially and physically.
Yeah, it's more fun to play the bad guy.
And how is it feeling for you two as one of Australia's favourite on-screen couples? What's going to happen when you don't have each other day to day? Is this going to feel like another
separation? Relief.
Susan Kinski, I was wondering if you would do me the honour of becoming my wife. Again? Three times has got to be lucky.
We've come to such a wonderful understanding about each other, and we think the same way, we laugh at the same things, that's probably the thing I'm going to miss the most, is having to, you know, work. I don't know if I can work with anyone else.
No.
How much have you enjoyed Carl and Susan and their journey on camera? We've had ups, we have had downs, we have had things that we can't remember. We've had slaps.
Don't you touch me!
You've also been television parents, having these young actors and actresses coming through that you've seen grow up and then move on like a real family. How has that been for you?
That bond was there from the very beginning, and it stayed that way. Mm. It's been an absolute privilege to have so many children without a single stretch mark.
Now, when it comes to the last day, have you thought about how you will be on set?
Mm. So you're just saying that's going to make me go. Yeah, no, I can't even think about it.
I think I'm going to be a bit of a mess.
So many memories and enough deaths to fill a small cemetery. Todd. Helen.
No, she's not asleep.
Daphne.
It's Daphne, she's waking up!
Put me down, Dad. Cardiac arrest.
Madge.
I love you. Go to Paris. Go for me.
What have been some of your favourite on-screen moments that Toadie has been through?
The Toadie and Sonia's death episode. I loved working with Eve, and we had, you know, such an incredible bond.
Sonia, no.
Neighbours has been at the forefront of many groundbreaking moments in Australian television. Of course, the same-sex wedding was a very important and significant storyline.
I, Aaron James Brennan, choose to share my life with you, David Yoshi Tanaka.
We didn't know while we were writing that story that it was going to become legal. We were going to do it anyway.
Can I get an amen?
It's not only a wrap for the actors, but also for the hundreds of crew and production staff who have worked on the series over many years.
it's an extended family out there into the community, into the industry. Yeah. There's so many people trained here.
And that dynamic of family too, where, you know, as with your real family, you see each other through some ups and downs, and you see people at their worst, you see people at their best. I mean, you know, we've watched the crew, births, deaths, marriages.
Jason and his team have pulled the stops out to deliver a blockbuster finale. Kylie and Jason have come back. So has Margot Robbie, Guy Pearce, and a host of other actors for whom Neighbours was a springboard to stardom.
How do you wrap up?
Yeah.
37 years of stories, of characters, people that everyone at home feels that they love. Are there still a few surprises up your sleeve?
There are. So that's why I'm being very careful with what I say. But definitely, it's. I would say that the audience hopefully are going to find it a very fulfilling, enjoyable finale.
How would you sum up your time on Neighbours?
Because I've never known where it's all going to end up. I've really enjoyed actually bringing it to people and being part of people's lives and. You know, it's been my life.
I reckon you're the one who's going to be begging for mercy once you've met the lawman!
You reckon?
Oh, I reckon!
I'll tell you what I reckon. I reckon you are just all mouth.
It's meant a happy life.
Yeah, it's given us enormous opportunities, work opportunities and personal opportunities. And, you know, I mean, you know this, but the greatest artistic pleasure I've had is working with Jackie. It's been...
No, you haven't
got it. Yeah, it's really been remarkable. She's a beautiful, beautiful actress, probably one of the best in the country, and I've fed off that for 28 years.
Right back at you, my friend, right back at you.
Well, on behalf of all of us as fans, I just want to say thank you very much for all you have done to be part of this incredible piece of our lives. Thank you for being such great neighbours.
Bless you. And thank you to all the wonderful, wonderful members of the audience who have supported us all these years.
So grateful, thank you.
That's when good neighbours become good friends.
Made it look like a
die. No, but that's the beauty of that show, right? And because, I mean, it's older than me. It's such an icon of this country. But also, like, if anyone says, that's when good neighbours, everyone knows the answer to that. Everyone can finish that sentence because everyone's kind of, at some point in their life, has probably grown up watching this show and grown up to see the talent on that show grow up and achieve such... incredible things.
What a star factory it's been too. Yeah. 9,000 episodes, more than 100 kidnappings, 35 natural disasters, 115 car crashes, 64 deaths, 39 weddings and 17 births.
And it's mostly cursed, isn't it?
Yes. I mean, it's quite realistic, really, isn't it?
By the way, trying to pick with your fiancé.
Yes.
What a horrible person on Neighbours.
I know. Yes, my fiancé, Finn Kelly, for any Neighbours fans out there, he had every single soap story you could have. Like, he went missing on a mountain, he fell off a cliff, he got amnesia, he had a secret brother, he killed people with a bow and arrow, he came back as a ghost twice.
And he was responsible for that car explosion.
That car explosion did that, yep.
And we should give a big shout out to everyone around the country who is having Neighbours parties tonight because the final ever episode of Neighbours will be airing on 10 and 10 Peach right after us at 7:30. And a particularly big shout out to everyone in Fed Square in Melbourne tonight. That's going to be huge.